Hi, welcome to Savvy's Fashion Studio. I'm Savita. In this video, I'll quickly show how to use the gathering or shearing foot with your commercial or industrial sewing machine. Both these presser feet are for gathering or shearing, and this looks like a regular foot but has a screw at the back which is used to control the gathers, and the part number is P952. This one has a slot in here and the part number is P5. Let's see how both these work. Now, these are for industrial or commercial sewing machines. If you have an electric home sewing machine or a domestic machine, you may get gathering foot similar to this one. So first, let's see the presser foot with part number P952. Install the presser foot the same way as you do with other presser feet. As I always say, once you install the presser foot, lower the needle slowly with the handwheel and see that it does not hit the presser foot. If it does, you know there is an adjustment to be done here, which is shown in our previous class. So this is fine now. I've taken a strip of fabric and let's gather this fabric. I've kept the stitch length at 2. And I am demonstrating on my Juki DDL900B industrial sewing machine. Now, I have not done any changes to the setting. I am just starting to sew. And let's see how the fabric gathers. Now, if you see, the gather is negligible. That is almost nothing. Now, turn the screw and tighten. More you tighten the screw, more gathers you get. And always before trying on the garment itself, try it on a scrap fabric. And once you're satisfied with the gathering of the fabric, then try it on the actual fabric. Now, let's try. Now, you see the gathering is more. Again, you can tighten it more. For even more gathers, you also need to tighten the thread tension. Try little by little and see, and stop only when you're satisfied. And also, for more gathers, change to a bigger stitch length. I'm keeping it 3. Now let's see. Now if you see, the gathers are more closer, that is denser, than before. Now if you want to reduce, loosen the tension and reduce the stitch length, or if you want even more gathers, you can keep the stitch length to the max, that is 4 in my machine. Now the gathering is even more closer. So you will have to do all these 3 adjustments and see which one works for you. So try it on a scrap fabric and then decide. As you change the thread tension or the stitch length or tightening or loosening of the screw, this gathering density changes. So decide how you want it to be. Now let's see how this presser foot works. That is part number P5. And if you see here, there is a slot. I'll show why the slot is. You can buy this on a website, servicefashionstudio.com, and also you can check out other full-fledged online sewing classes. So let's install the presser foot. There are 2 different ways this presser foot can be used. First, let's see how to make our gathers in a single layer of fabric. Place it under the presser foot and place it such that the needle is on the seam line. That is, for example, if you want the seam at 1/2 inch from the edge, place it in that way so that the needle is 1/2 inch in from the edge. You can follow the marking on your machine or you can use a seam guide. Now start sewing. Now you can control the gathers, that is, you can make it less or more by increasing the thread tension. The more tighter it is, the more gathers you get. If you want lesser gathers, loosen it slightly. And also, by increasing or decreasing the stitch length, longer the stitch length, more gathered the fabric will be. So I have kept at 3. As you sew, don't hold this fabric tight. This needs to gather and needs to move freely. So just hold it to guide the fabric, that's all. Very softly you need to hold. Now there are different ways to gather the fabric. You can do a basting stitch and just gather it manually. But this foot helps by taking very less time to do the same gathers, and also the gathers will be uniform than when you do it manually. Now let's see the other way of doing the gathers. Now suppose you want to gather one fabric and attach it to the other, in which the other fabric will not be gathered. You can do it simultaneously. Place the fabric that you want to gather under the presser foot, that is, lift the presser foot and place it, and lower the presser foot so that the fabric does not move. Now take the fabric to which the gathers need to be attached and insert it in the slot here. Insert it completely and keep the fabric straight. Now this guide here does not let this fabric go beyond this point, and this fabric needs to be controlled by me, very softly holding it. The lower fabric is gathering and getting attached to this fabric on top simultaneously. Now as I sew, I am not looking at the needle at all. I am only focusing that this fabric is aligned to this guide all the time and this fabric is completely inserted in the slot. If you don't focus here, this may come out of the slot and you may not even realize. So keep the focus here. Don't look at the needle. And also I'm just holding this with just one finger very lightly. If I press it too hard, it will not gather. If you see this is moving away from the guide, guide it back to the place. So this has gathered beautifully, and if you see here, the seam is even. Now if this is to be put as a frill at the hem of the skirt, you can turn it and do a top stitch here. Now when you do such gathers, where the gathers are attached to another fabric, you need to take this fabric which needs to be gathered almost double or three times more than the other fabric to which it is attached. Now let me show just another variation. Now if you are doing layered skirt, you can place all the layers together. So for example, if it's three layered skirt, I'll place three layers together and we can gather it together. This foot works for light to medium weight fabric. If the fabric is too thick, it's a little difficult to use it. So if you see here, all the three layers are equally gathered. This makes it so easy to make a gathered layered skirt. Now all this while we used cotton fabric. Now let's also try with net fabric. So let's see how this gathers. So it works beautifully on this net fabric also. Thanks for watching this video. For more full-fledged online classes, please check our website servicefashionstudio.com. So see you soon in the next class. Until then, happy sewing!